Considered a value point. Oh, we have Pounce on No Tail. He's gonna put Shadow Word on himself. He's taking blood. That's gonna be first blood going the way of Yol on the silencer. So,
was a tough decision to make.
This Curse of the Silent is so annoying, especially when you can get it on all three targets. Finally, Puppy has absolutely mana. Does have a couple stick charges, and he's gonna get pounced on. BZZ is gonna try to do as much damage as possible. Miskold coming out as well, but that was actually used defensively. I guess it doesn't really matter. They're gonna get the kill on Puppy regardless. Courier coming out, bringing something very important. Looks like a bottle for Simba, but No Tail, unfortunately. He does have six charges on his wand. Okay, he might actually get out of this. Miskoil is available, level 2. Pounce is gonna connect though, and the last hit going the way of BZZ. Simultaneously, Yol will TP out in the midst of almost getting kills. Jotam.
What do you think about Sadoi going for a null talisman? This is very unusual on Weaver.
Well, let's talk
is
about Puppy first.
Flat monopole?
He is in all likelihood dead.
Okay.
Dream of Pain finishes him off.
Middle of nowhere.
Well, S4 is actually coming in. There's three people here though. He does have Flame Guard activated, so no magic damage is going to be taken for the most part. Oh, Sonic Wave though! Bagging all the way, for sure.
But it's nice to have that extra flat mana burst in the lane. I think it's more important than the agility, and he has that he would have got from Wraithbane, and he already has an Aquila for that. So maybe it's just
super aggressive. We're seeing it on people use. It's actually going to force them away. And BZZ stuck in the trees. Puppy could go for this, but it's just way too much damage.
Nice play from
Jotam
as well. He suicides himself and brings Puppy low enough for BZZ to get the kill in the same move. And now G is gonna find the Warlock of No Tail. No mana though. He can int thread switch.
But more levels in farm. Perhaps he can get a. If he can get like a decently timed Blink Dagger, bottom lane, we're gonna have a pounce. Axes. Unfortunately, Simba just doesn't have his roar yet, so he's pretty much food.
Neither BKB nor what's that? What would he get? Bloodstone? Like a build up to that? He could get a point booster or a vitality booster and maybe be somewhat tanky. Oh, BZZ.
Not gonna find the pound.
Slark is hard enough to kill as it is. With a Baton on his side, he is disgusting.
And pretty disgusting to say the least. BZZ does get the pounce on S4, but his remnant is like melee range. Look how slow it is. It's ridiculous, Kuroki. Oh, actually, Puppy's gonna come and get a nice Berserker's Call, but the heals continue, like you said. What can he do against a Slark with an Abaddon, especially when they have the level advantage? They're gonna get a second easy kill. Kuroki still has some mana to work with. I think he'll be okay, although
Sadoi,
G,
solos, G no tell me
have, oh, he does have Sonic Wave now. Doesn't
oh,
even need
God.
It. What level?
It's such a good lineup to have a Baton for. Like Slark, Weaver, and Pop,
oh,
all three of them really
looks like they will get
him.
A kill. Global Silence will probably come. Nope, he will just fall to the ground. Here's Chaotic Offering, he's on BZZ. But here comes the TP support, so really the Chaotic Offering is completely wasted. S4, oh, beautiful! Sonic Wave on 3, it's not enough to get a kill right off the bat, however. This is gonna force Secret back, though. And the aggression continues. Puppy initiates onto Slark. Can he get up to Culling Boom? Well, Slark does fall to the ground, so I guess that works for that Big Daddy. Looks like he'll go down to the Shadow Wave, or Shadow Strike, I should say.
This is their
Blink
best
dagger
chance.
Available.
Flanking and getting an opening is their absolute best chance.
Oh, they don't
want
to go on Jotam, though. They're just going to completely ignore him. Okay, never mind. They're going to Blink Berserker's Call. Silence on S4. Can they burst him down? The Global Silence to follow S4, taking so much damage. And without that mobility, thanks to being silenced, he is literally useless.
Yol's globals have been really good all game. I don't think he's had a single.
No Tail. Oh boy. Well, they should be able to pick him up. Oh, Puppy, a nice Berserker's Call though. Can they find Slark? He pops his ultimate. Chaotic Offering on 3. Very good ultimate. The best he could really ask for in this situation. But 2 dead for Secret already. And the rest on the runner. Oh my god, the Scream of Pain. Finishes off the third member. And the aggression continues. This is just an absolute stomp. BZZ, is he gonna live? Where is the Aphotic Shield? Nope. Miskoil was actually in range too. So, Jotam a little bit of a Miskoil there.
Overextended. Here comes Sadoi.
He has no mana either.
He's gonna
and
clean
them
up.
So this is gonna be a complete team wipe. Going the way of VP, double kill for Sadoi. S4's
trying to bring up the gold graph. And
well,
look at the bottom. Look at
here.
The bottom of it. Oh, wait
Hold
a second.
Horses. Hold your horses, because there's a dead horse that denies himself. Thanks to that Miskoil.
I don't know how many denies we've had in our tournament, but I feel like it's been like 50.
Quite a bit.
It's insanely many denies. Oh, Orchid on S4.
Oh man, they don't have Sonic Wave to work with.
What are you gonna do?
Matter. Yeah, there's nothing you can do. Puppy comes and initiates a very nice Berserker's Call. Oh, the Calling Blade is actually dodged to the time lapse.
No, it just wasn't enough.
Oh, was it?
He didn't set off.
I thought it canceled half its animation.
Kuro gets last worded, now orchided. Oh boy.
This is literally
this is not gonna that they've had for like the last 5 to 8 minutes. They were just already so far behind that it didn't even seem to matter anymore.
They put all their eggs in the tri-lane, really.
Yeah, really did. And it didn't work.
And then they lost the other lanes as well, which didn't help, obviously. Okay, Jonathan gets caught out. He's gonna put a Fauna Shield on himself. Yul gets initiated out. They're gonna focus on him first. Silencer already uses a Global Silence, so he's not of the biggest use anyway. Okay, well, he might actually live. Oh my god, even the Mistcloak and the Fauna Shield. He uses Chaotic Offering on a couple, but Axe is the first one to die. Sonic Wave is there as well. Hiroki is the next on the list. S4 should be able to TP out. Takes a little bit of damage on the way out, though. Three dead, make it four. Ultra kill on the way to Sendoi, and GG's coming out. VP.
Oh my goodness.
They are looking so good.
Yeah, well, as we talked about earlier, they came in today. If they get a win today, they're looking to perhaps even get first place. So as we talked about, they had a lot more to win than Secret had to lose. As to what extent Secret went in with the mentality that they're already safe in the top four and how much that impacted their game today, I don't know. It's very hard to call just from the way they played, but.